Following the initial release of AMD Ryzen, there was a ton of discussion in regards to using higher clocked system RAM. Particularly in games, the performance benefits of having higher clocked memory was something that we didn't necessarily see on Intel's side. It's just not how the architecture is made. It's not made to benefit from higher clocked memory, but Ryzen's architecture is, and that's what I want to talk about in this video, if it's worth buying really expensive high clocked RAM out of the box for the sake of a Ryzen CPU. And a lot of the people who spend, you know, $400 on an 1800X are probably going to buy higher clocked Ryzen memory anyway, at least memory that's capable of reaching 3000 or 3200 megahertz on the Ryzen platform, which is difficult to do. We'll talk about that as well. But for those who are in the mid-range Ryzen 5 tier, should you still consider fast memory? And why does it even matter in the first place? We're going to talk about all that in this video. Now, when it comes down to it, all Ryzen CPUs on a fabrication level are basically the same. There are a few imperfections in some of the cores, and that is ultimately what differentiates a Ryzen 3 CPU from a Ryzen 7 CPU. So of the 8 cores that are packed into every Ryzen chip, no matter if you have a Ryzen 3 up to a Ryzen 7 CPU, if 4 of those aren't doing too well, then AMD is going to just disable them. They're just going to turn them off. It's better than making an entirely new fabrication process for a 4-core chip. This way they can save money. Makes perfect sense. I don't blame them for doing that. So of the 4 remaining cores, if these can handle power loads pretty well, and the, you know, the performance degradation isn't too substantial, then these might be Ryzen 5 1400s or 1500Xs. If they aren't doing too well with handling a lot of power and the schedulers aren't doing that great a job at increasing the performance level, then they might be Ryzen 3 CPUs with multi-threading disabled. So it really comes down to what AMD deems as acceptable on both power delivery and execution levels. Now, the difference between AMD and Intel, because Intel does this too with binning, is that AMD decides, well, if these 4 cores aren't going to cut it, we're going to disable 2 of the cores in one CCX, which is a 4-core cluster in a Ryzen CPU, and 2 cores in the other CCX, which is the other cluster of cores in a Ryzen CPU. Every Ryzen CPU has 2 CCXs per die. Threadripper has 4, which is why you can get up to 16 cores in those CPUs. Maybe this die shot will help explain things a bit better. So if 2 cores are activated in one CCX and 2 are activated in the other, there has to be some sort of efficient way for them both to communicate, because these are essentially 2 separate dies. They might not be that physically, but each core cluster has its own set of resources, including L3 cache, which means that when you're in especially intense situations on a computational level and they have to share information and process information simultaneously and exchange resources, there has to be an efficient highway, a way for data to be transferred super quick between the cores to eliminate that latency. This highway is called the Infinity Fabric. As Tom's Hardware puts it, the large amount of data flowing through this pathway requires a lot of scheduling magic to ensure a high quality of service. It's also logical to assume that the 6 and 4 core models benefit from less cross CCX traffic compared to the 8 core models. So what they're actually hinting at here is the dual CCX design is a blessing in a way and a curse. It's a blessing for AMD from a financial standpoint, because all they have to do is slap multiple CCXs into the same chip and just run Infinity Fabric all between them, which saves them money because they can control how many CCXs are in each die without completely redoing the fabrication process. But the curse involved is the latency involved between the CCX data transfers. So the Infinity Fabric itself is not the most efficient means by which data is transferred from one CCX to another. This is where the faster memory comes into play. It's what this whole video is about. Why Ryzen benefits from faster memory. When you hear people say that, maybe they don't know what they're talking about, but they are correct in a sense. It really depends on the number of cores enabled per CCX, but ultimately, Ryzen will benefit more from faster memory than Intel will. And the reason why is because the Infinity Fabric speed, the rate at which it can transfer data, is directly tied to the frequency of your system memory. Intel isn't dependent on the same variable because their consumer grade CPUs are reliant on the ring bus design. 2 rings share information between, let's say, 4 cores, and basically you have less traffic being dispatched between cores. So the congestion isn't as great as it would be on an 8-core Ryzen CPU, because then you have 4 cores trying to share information down, let's say, a single pathway with the Infinity Fabric, so there can be quite a bit of congestion and lag. Well, I shouldn't say lag, it's more or less a gamer term, but latency. It's the delay in data transfer, and we see a huge difference between the ring bus design with Intel, a comparable Intel CPU, and the Infinity Fabric. fabric. Whereas cores on an i7-7700K rely on a latency roughly between 30 and 40 nanoseconds, cross-core to core latency on a CCX array for Ryzen is somewhere in the realm of 200 nanoseconds, almost 10 times the latency just because data has to be transferred across an Infinity fabric. Now, to be frank, we're talking nanoseconds here, not even milliseconds, but it does add up over time as huge computational workloads bottleneck that Infinity fabric. You can imagine how things get pretty backed up in the long run, and you might even be able to tell a difference in things like games and also in render times. If you do have heavy workloads being pushed to Ryzen CPUs, they might not be able to handle them as well with that lower clocked system RAM. So there you have it. Yes, AMD Ryzen CPUs do benefit from higher clocked memory. It's not a myth, and the reason why is because AMD employs the Infinity fabric, which is directly dependent on the speed of your RAM. Without getting too much into detail, that's really all you need to know. Something else worth noting is that Ryzen 3 CPUs, because they only have two cores activated per CCX, aren't going to benefit as much from the higher clocked RAM, only because the data transfer rates between CCXs aren't going to be as high, because only two cores per CCX are actually sending information. Whereas in a Ryzen 7, 1700, 1700X, or 1800X CPU, you got four cores on each side sending a ton of information. Things can get pretty congested in there. For more info on this, maybe you'd like to read an article about the Infinity Fabric, I invite you to check out the link at the top of this video's description. Sometimes it helps to just read something over and over until it clicks. Usually takes me 5 or 6 times. I'm like, I'm gonna keep reading the sentence until something clicks. You get that light bulb go off and, oh, okay, I get it now. It's harder to do that with a video because you have to keep hearing me say it over and over again. It's less annoying when you're doing it yourself in your head. I invite you to check that link out, by the way. It's linked to Tom's Hardware, and they have a great article breaking down the Infinity Fabric and why it behaves the way it does. Also, some pretty cool benchmarks in there to back up the claims made in this video. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. I appreciate it. Thumbs down for the opposite. Click the subscribe button if you haven't already, and stay tuned for more content like this. This is Science Studio. Thanks for learning with us.